Dear children, welcome to the puppet show. Radha and Shyam, age 6 and 8, have gone to visit their grandmother, Shanti, during the summer vacation. Shanti is a retired school teacher and lives in a village that is far away from the hustle and bustle of the city life. The children love this place because it was calm and serene, and they loved waking up to the kukurukoo sounds in the morning. Hearing the sound, the children rush towards the gulawala in a bid to get their gulas first. Children were already pushing each other for their share of gula by that time.
Bhaiya, 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 I want one red gola, bhaiya, bhaiya.
The golawala does not hear her request because of the noise the children were making. So, Radha pushes and squeezes her way to get closer to the golawala and asks once again.
Bhaiya, one red gola, please.
The golawala catches her squeaky voice and notices her small hand reaching out to him for the gola. He grins and takes out a gola for her.
Here is your delicious red gola, little one.
Thank you so much, bhaiya. I'm so happy and excited. Please take the money.
Bhaiya, bhaiya, give me the blue one.
Gola uncle, I want yellow one.
No, no, give me kesar.
I want green.
As Radha turns to leave, because of the push and pull, she drops her gola. She gets very upset and starts crying.
Radha, what happened? Why are you crying?
I dropped my gola because someone pushed me. I could not eat also, and it spilled on my dress.
Please stop crying. Come, I'll take you home. Let's see what can be done.
What happened, dear? Who made my little one cry?
Grandma, we wanted to be the first to get the golas. But by the time we reached, already there were quite a few children crowding around the gola wala. Radha still entered the crowd and grabbed her share of the gola. But before she could come out, because of the pushing and pulling, she dropped her gola, Grandma.
Yes, Grandma. Actually, the children pushed me and I could not save my gola also.
It is really sad, Radha, that you could not eat your gola. But my dear children, do you know why the gola fell down from Radha's hands?
I already told you, Grandma, somebody pushed me from behind and gola slipped from my hands.
Look at those ants carrying sugar crystals and walking in a line. Do you see them following one another in a disciplined manner, or do you see them going around without any order?
Granny, they are just walking like how we walk in our school, in a line, one behind the other, no pushing or pulling. Oh, it's looking so orderly.
So what does this remind you? Discipline, isn't it?
Yes, true. But we need to follow certain rules only in the school, right?
No. You are mistaken, dear. Discipline is required everywhere. Okay, now let me tell you a story about a girl by the name Lata, who felt discipline is not that very important.
Lata, wake up! It's time to get ready to school. Your bus is going to be here soon.
Mommy, please let me sleep for another 5 minutes.
Lata, you're so lazy. This laid-back attitude will put you in trouble one day.
Oh, come on, Mommy. Please calm down. Don't worry.
This was Lata's daily routine. Lata finally gets up and gets ready after repeated reminders from her mother. But she misses the school bus, which had become a regular feature. Her mother was quite disturbed with her lethargic, unplanned way of life.
What shall I do with this girl? She's so casual and irresponsible. I don't know when she will realize that she has to be more disciplined.
After a few days, Lata was returning home from school. She seemed excited. Even you all look excited when something nice happens to you at school, right?
Mommy! Mommy!
Yes, dear Lata.
Tomorrow I have a music competition in the first period. I'm eagerly waiting to participate. I have really practiced well.
Oh, I see. All the best, my dear.
The next day, Lata's mother does not wake her up at the usual time. It is 9 a.m. Lata suddenly gets up and runs to her mother in panic.
Mommy, it is 9. Why didn't you wake me up? You know how important this music competition was for me. I spent the whole of last evening practicing for it.
Calm down. Please stop crying, Lata.
You don't realize how important this competition was for me. Mommy, please help me out. I promise you that from tomorrow I'll wake up on time and not trouble you anymore. Can you please take permission and ensure that I don't miss this competition?
Stop crying now. I have already taken the permission from your class teacher. She has agreed to postpone the competition to the fourth period. You have not missed your chance and you can still participate.
Thank you, Ma. Thank you so much.
Okay. Now, do not forget to thank your kind teacher and friends who made sure you participate in the competition.
Lata leaves for school, wondering about how her friends and teacher would react to the situation. She finds everyone relaxed, but she takes part in the music competition with a feeling of guilt.
God love, it's so beautiful, God love. So wonderful, God's love. It's so beautiful, God's love. It's so wonderful, God's love. It's so beautiful, oh, wonderful love. So high,
You can't get over it so deep. You can't get under it so high. You can't get over it so deep. You can't get under it. Oh, wonderful love.
That night, as Lata goes over the events of the day, she understands how her lethargy and an indisciplined lifestyle almost made her miss the competition that day. She also realizes that she could end up with a trail of missed opportunities if this trend continues. The first step she takes in this regard is to set an alarm for 6 a.m. the next day, with a promise to herself that she will get more order into her life. So, dear children, what do you learn from Lata's story?
Grandma, we learned that we should not be lazy, Grandma.
And should be disciplined always.
So, my dear children, we should realize that it is important to be disciplined and not to break rules by seeing others. We need to set an example for others to follow us.
Dear children, hope you all like the puppet show and remember to be disciplined always.